welcome to the channel. On this video we're going to talk about how I paint Space Marines, or more specifically how I painted these Space Marines. We're going to go through it step by step. Before we get to the painting stage, I'm going to talk just a little bit about assembling them and some of the tips and tricks you can use to make them look good. So when I paint and assemble my guys, I try and make them look as unique as possible with the limited skills that I have. I found out that it mainly comes down to the pose. Try and get as good a pose as possible, and it doesn't really matter if you're an average painter like me, you can still make them look pretty good. So here's a sample of my Space Marines from my chapter, and I want to talk you a bit through the process of assembling and painting, what I'm thinking about when I assemble and paint some Space Marines. So here's a sample of sergeants, please focus. And the thing I want to point out here is all of my sergeants have got white rims on their shoulder pads, as you can see. Another theme that you'll see repeated in my chapter again and again is the grenade belts, cluster of grenades around the legs, or fuel canisters, extra fuel canisters on flamer troops. Another theme that I repeat, as you can see from these models, is the dagger or sword option hanging down the back of their backpack. I like this guy here, this guy's pretty groovy. In this selection here, I want to point out the shoulder pads. As you can see, they're not standard Space Marine shoulder pads, they're Chaos Space Marine shoulder pads, which I swapped with a friend. And also some of the backpacks there, some of the Forge World Mark II Iron Armor backpacks. You may have noticed in some of the battle reports that my Stern Guard are Mark II Iron Armor Space Marines. In this selection, you can see the grenade pouches, or the pouches on the right shoulder pad, and also another theme coming through is all the purity seals, a bit like flares on the trousers on the lower parts of the legs. So I've got a number of themes running through it, and that helps them stand out, that helps them be a little bit more unique than the typical Space Marines you might see. My reasoning for it is I've got a whole background, a whole fluff behind my chapter. They're Renegade Space Marines. They're many different chapters that have come together, have been excommunicated from the Empire, and we rely on using older pieces of equipment, older pieces of war gear, hence the Forge World stuff, hence the old Horus Heresy era bits that are in the armor here, in the army here or there. It's just a way to increase their unique appeal. Here's another example of Horus Heresy stuff bleeding through into my chapter. The old marks of las cannon and multi-melter there. What this all comes down to is posing correctly and kit bashing. Kit bashing is using lots of pieces of bits from different boxes, different sources. And here's the stuff I use, basically. It's a spares box, lots of bits from all over the place, good for bases, and there'll be arms and heads and other bits in there. Forge World bits, all mixed together by now. Some spare sprues, leftover sprues, bike parts. I think this is from a Devastator set. These are very interesting. The minimum you need, if you want to put together some tactical Space Marines, the minimum I suggest you get you need is the tactical Space Marines and another kit. Assault kits are good. Mix and match your assault guys with your tactical guys. But the best thing you can do is buy this. This is the Stern Guard plastic kit. And there are some very interesting options on here. Lots of different heads, lots of different arm poses. You get all the weapon options that you might want, that you might need, and lots of very groovy shoulder pads. So here's a good example of some basic kit bashing. This is an assault marine body and head, and the gun I got from the tactical kit, backpack from Forge World, and there we have standard tactical marine with his bolt pistol, bolt gun, running forward. Notice the pouches on the shoulder and the grenade clusters around the belt. nice effective looking marine. So back to these guys, the sergeant has got a stern guard left shoulder pad and helmet. This guy's got the purity seals around his right leg and he stood on an ammo box that I got out of my spares. So this guy's got a grenade cluster around his leg and the body comes from a bike kit. And this guy, the flame is from Forge World, the legs are from Assault Marine kit and the left shoulder pad is a Chaos Space Marine shoulder pad. Okay, so let's go back to the main theme of this tutorial. Let's find out how I assembled and painted these guys. I just wanted to point out the thread running through the army, the themes of that I like to try and stick with when I build and make Space Marines. So let's go back to the beginning. So get all your bits out, clean off the mold lines and use extra bits. Start putting them together without putting any glue on it and figuring out what it'll look like when it's done, what works well together. Okay, I want to say that this is a pro tip, but I'm about as professional as a spoon. So this is a tip. Legs, bodies, last. So stuck these legs down, stuck this body together, put it on this guy, put it on this guy, twist and turn, see which one works best. Decided not to go with that one. Gonna go with this one. The stand's a lot more dramatic. I think this one will be a guy running forward with a couple of pistols or something later. So that one goes back into the spare box. And then the body gets stuck to the legs. And the last thing, always do the head last. The head and the angle of your body will make the model look as dramatic as possible. So you can see on this guy, for example, decided to have him at full pelt, running forward, his head looking up the barrel of the gun, whereas this chap a lot more static and followed the same principle with these two as I am gonna follow with this one. This is what the four of them look like stuck together. I'd use the same principles, follow the same principles with bolt guns as I would with these specialist weapons guys. So remember to get as dramatic poses as possible, stick the waists and the legs together at the last possible second and the heads on at the last possible second. Yeah, I'm going to put sand on these guys now, but you could use sterling mud or some of those textured base paint things as well. I'm going to put some sand on them though. So there we go with sand on the bases. Leave it to dry and normally wait overnight for it to dry. And then tomorrow we'll spray them black and start the painting process. Spray them black and then start adding the layers of paint. Although it's tempting to start with the bulk blue colour of the armour straight away, we don't want to do that. We want to focus on the little nooks and crannies and the cracks and then add the blue. So, yeah. Okay, so we're building up the colours layer by layer. Next stop, Castellan Green. And what we're going to do is paint all the lowest areas of the model in Castellan Green. And I like to put some of the green on the guns. After this, we're going to do some silvers, then some blues. Slowly pick out each individual bit on the model until the whole model is painted. So let's take a look. This guy, you can see the green in the cabling between the power armor. And of course, splodges on the base there. And I like to do my greens in this Castellan Green colour as well. My greens, the guns in the Castellan Green colour. Because it's a very forgiving colour. And when I come to dry brushing the weapons, it will look fine. So you can see it there. And in the cracks, also around the hands. So now we're on to the silver bits. What silver? I used Lead Belcher, which is a base colour. In this stage you want to have a dark silver. It's the undercoat to what else we're going to do. So silver everywhere, silver everywhere. There might be bits that you can't get to. There might be bits underneath and around the back of the backpacks that you can't actually reach with the brush, which is fine. There'll be black undercoat there, and that's where all your wash will go, And it'll look shaded, it'll look dark, it'll be hidden away. And when people peer close at it, they'll just see it's dark and shaded as it should be. So a couple more things to note. I'm gonna do the condenser coils on the plasma guns as a coppery color. I like copper. I know the current fashion is to do these things shiny blue. I've been doing them copper for a while. And whenever you want to do a copper or a gold or a light metallic color, you always need silver underneath to begin with. It makes the color pop out. One last thing on the spiky bits of metal on the base, like that. Focus. Don't let the silver go all the way down onto your base. Leave it a black gap in between where the sheets of metal end and the base starts. Damn it. Finishing off the silver bits, add in Rune Lord Brass. So you can leave the silver bits just plain silver if you want to, but splodges of brass here or there help break up the plainness of the color palette. And you'll notice on the back of this guy, half of it brass on one side, half of it silver on the other side. Don't want it all to look the same. So the metal will look quite textured when it's done. So splodges of brass here or there, you can see on this guy as well. Splodges of brass, particularly in the dark bits, in the cracks and in the corners and the crevices. And also on the bases, on the metal bits on the bases. So focus and pipes at the back there. But that's pretty much it. Splodges of brass to break up the one color palette on the metal. Quick shout out to Mini Wargaming. I'd like to have Matt sit and talks in the background while I do this. Listen to him chatter on and on and on. Hi, Matt. The last thing to do with the metal is a bit of gold, and I put the gold on the bases there in splodges, because when you wash the bases, then highlight and dry brush on top of these bits of twisted metal on the bottom, you don't want them to look uniform, you don't want them to look just silver. So they've got silver on it, they've got brass on it, they've got a bit of gold on it. You can also put touches of a dark red here or there if you really want a rusty effect. In fact, I'll probably do that before I'm done. And also put gold on these bits. Has this one got gold on the back? No. This one got gold on the back? No. This one? It's this one. This one's also got a bit of gold on the coils on the suit at the back there, and spiky bits on the base, particularly around the edges of the spiky bits where the light will catch. Yeah, so now I've done the green, I've done the metal, and you can see, focus, you can see that I've got it all over parts of the model that shouldn't be on parts of the model. Is that a sentence? So now I'm going to paint the power armor. I do power armor blue. You can do green, red, whatever, pink, whatever color you guys want to do your army in. But now paint it all blue, and I'll have the base hidden bits, the green bits done. I'll have the metal bits done, and then the blue will allow me to then sit back and have a look at the remaining parts of the model and start to pick out the last bits of details. So lower level details, then hit your power armor, then do your upper level details. Yep, blue everywhere. I use enchanted blue. I don't know what the equivalent is now. And now I can focus on the other parts of the model. Start picking out the colors, finishing off all the base colors. You'll notice that I don't paint all of the back plaques blue, just the top bit, leave silver around the bottom bits. It's just slightly different from what most people do to allow the models to stand out. Fits in with the philosophy of a renegade Space Marine chapter. Everything's slightly different. Just a bit of color, a bit of War Boss green on the frag grenades there, and also on that ammo crate. I'm going to do the crack grenade yellow. To do yellow, you need a white base underneath it first. To do red, you need a white base underneath it first. So there's a few dots of red on these models, and a bit of yellow, and quite a lot of white. So I think I'll do the white now. Just a note on white. White is a terrible color to paint with. Women and children run screaming from white. So I use layer white. I use a nice thick white, and it still sucks. White white everywhere on the helmets, on the yellow bottles, on the flamer, on the shoulder pads. White around the rims of the shoulder pads for the sergeant, because that's what I do. On the purity seals, white everywhere. Sunburst yellow on the yellow bits, on the crack grenades, and on the flamer canisters. Adding touches of bright color like this to the model really helps them pop. What's the name of the flamer fluid that they put in flamers? Promethean canisters? I forget. It's a Dan Abnett thing. Must study Gaunt's ghosts. Dark red, corn red on all the wax seals of the Oaths of Moment. Polish chicken soup. Thanks for the soup, baby.
That's okay.
I definitely need more blood red. Anyway, blood red on the eyes, on the laser pointer things, on the guns, and more chicken soup. You can paint the Aquila on the chest plates any color you want. I like grey, Dawnstone grey. It adds to the muted feel of my chapter. Just tidying up now, focus. Bit of brown on the utility belt there. Brown and grey splodges on the base. I'm just going to tidy up, have a look for the bits of metal. Tidy up. Aquila on the gun, that's going to be gold. Back of this thing. I don't like a big white Aquila, probably make that one gold. One of these has got, green. I'm going to put green. So just tidy up the last bits of colour here or there. And any areas where you may splodged over, obviously the red of the eyes, do around them. I'm going to do all that, get them all tidy, then show you what they look like. Yeah, I think I'm pretty much there. A bit of copper on the copper coils on the plasma guns. Copper and gold touched on the front of that flamer there. Tidied up the eyes. Bit of green round his hat. His hat. Yeah, just look at the little bits of detail here or there which haven't got any colour on and put colour on them. So all the base colours are done. Still looking fairly plain. But all the base colours done. Right, then we get this stuff, Nuln oil, one of GW's greatest inventions before they had the other oil, which wasn't Nuln oil and doesn't leave a shine on the models like this stuff does. It's not as good as the other stuff, that's what I'm trying to say. If you don't have any oil, you can use a black paint. Abaddon black is good with lots of water, well, not lots, about 50-50 combo. And we're going to wash these guys in it. Focus underneath, start underneath the arms and between the legs and between the backpack and the body. Try not to let it pool anywhere because this stuff isn't as good as the other stuff. And wash them all nice, thin to medium coat all over. I'll show you once I'm done. Wash is done, nice coat all over the model. Wait for a couple of hours for it to dry. It needs to be completely dry before we highlight up from here. It doesn't have to look pretty at this stage because it will once we start highlighting. I'll put it on this so I don't get any marks on the table and get told off again. But that's it. Yeah. When the oil dries, it leaves this shiny effect, which is really nice for metallics, but not so good for armor and vehicles and other plain colors like the blue. But now we're going to go paint back up on top of the blue. We're going to paint back on top of the power armor, ignoring all the cracks and crevices. Crevices. So that the oil forms a natural shade. It's sunken into all the crevices, and you paint on the high areas with the blue, and you've got a two-tone effect or a three-tone effect. You've got the black, then you've got the dark blue with the wash on it, and then you've got the blue that we're putting back on top of it again. I'll start working on them and show you what it looks like. Focus. Here's an example of what I'm talking about. Top half of the model, no blue on it yet. Bottom half of the model, see the blue around the legs, not going all the way up to the cracks, focusing on the high areas. At the back, up his back there, you can see just a dash of blue, not going into the corners, under the shoulder pads, or around the back of the backpack. You don't have to go right round it where the legs are, in between the legs. So yeah, that's what the bottom part looks like. And you get this nice shaded effect. And that's what the top part looks like. Just with a wash and going back over it with blue again. It's a good effect, good cheap cheap, quick effect to do. So I'm going to finish off the rest of the model. So they're done. The second layer of blue back on top. As you can see, not going into the cracks, not going all the way to the edges. And then I add a lighter blue for all the edges. So if you're doing red, you'll want to do an orange on the edges. Greens or greys or anything like that, Citadel colors do a fantastic range of paints. Just pick a color that's lighter than the one that you used before. So when you've done highlighting the upper areas, it's going to look like this, a mess. Particularly if your hand is as steady as mine and you've lived a life of sin. So you're going to want to go back over the blue again to get rid of all the light blue overspill, the higher paint color overspill. So let's have a look. You can see where light blue I've done around the hands and around the chest part here is fine. I'm not going to need to do over that. Bit of blue around the backpacks there. Going to need to go a bit of blue over that. Backpack, I meant shoulders. The backpack's fine. This guy, the one that we've been focusing on, you can see blue on the backpack will need redoing. And around the legs, dark blue will need a bit of redoing as well. So you're focusing on the bits that the light would catch, like the edges of the shoulders, the edges of the backpacks, around the tips of the legs. But don't worry too much about the feet, because the feet are going to get a dry brush grey-brown with mud from the base. So that's what they look like once I've added the light blue on. Dark blue again. There's going to be a white highlight as well towards the end, which will make the really upper areas stand out a bit more. So yeah, you're getting the feeling of this? Blue, light blue, and then a bit more blue. Focus. And yeah, I'll get back to you after I've tidied them up. So we've tidied up the blue and it looks a bit like this. Everything's nice and tidy. So now we're gonna tidy up other stuff. The yellow, the greens, the reds, before we touch the white. Touching up the details, splodges of light green, that's moot green there on the head and on the backpack bit and on the frag grenades. Touches of yellow, just touches here and there on the high areas of the grenades and the canisters. And there were touches of red. Where's the guy with the... That's the guy with... So on the purity seals there, that was a blood red, just on touches, again. So just a dab here, a dab there, with lighter colours, really draws out these colours. The reds, the yellows, and the greens makes them pop. The models are almost finished now. I'm going to do some greys, and I'm going to do some whites. And I'm going to do some silvers, and there might be some other stuff, I forget. Anyway, let's go through it. Now, like... bright silver, we've got Runefang steel. We put it on the touches here on the gun. Tips of the bits up here, around the shoulder plates here, touches on the gun, and dry brushed the back of the backpack things. So it just makes the silver pop a little bit more. Just like you put touches on the green and on the yellow, we're putting touches of silver back on the silver. It makes these colours stand out, makes them pop just a little bit more. Now I've gone over the white again, same as with the blue, trying to avoid the cracks. Looking a lot better in places. Tidied up. Shoulder pads. Looking sharp. You could do them silver or gold, a different colour if you want to. I like the white. Suits my army, really. So now I'm going to dry brush brown on the bases, a muddy brown, and then I'm going to dry brush grey everywhere, and then dry brush white, and I'm done. Yeah, so dry brush Zambezi Desert on the bases. Don't be afraid to go up the feet and the legs a little bit, like that. Wait for it to dry, and then we're going to dry brush Dawnstone Grey. Okay, we're losing the light, which is why we're now up here doing this shot. I like to paint in daylight. Daylight gives you the best light. So grey, dry brush grey on the bases. You'll notice it's just done patches here or there. We're being quite subtle with the dry brush now. And the guns. While I'm dry brushing drawn stone grey, I go over the guns. So the edges of the guns stand out. And the details of the guns focus stand out more. Okay, dry brushing grey everywhere. Or also on the grey of the Aquila on the front of their chest plates there. This is it, you can stop there, but I like to do a nice, very, very fine white dry brush on just a few touches on the base and a few touches of the highest areas, so the highest parts of the gun, the highest parts of the backpack, and then I will be done. Right, so that's the white highlight done. The differences should be very subtle now, very hard to see, but if you look at this one in the foreground, along the top of the pistol and along the top of the plasma, there's a bit of white also on the tops of the backpacks. These are done pretty much. I'm going to put some heat flare around the front of the flamer, dry brush black on top of the front of the flamer. I'm going to paint black around the bases, glue a couple of tufts of grass on them, and leave these. I like them. I'll show you the finished shot after I've done all of those steps. Okay, we've done. We've got some tufts of grass stuck to a few bases there. And they look good. So the way to do this, the main thing to remember is get all your details on, get all your colours on before you do the wash. Tidy it all up before you do the wash. Then a black wash. A black wash is very forgiving. It will hide most of the little mistakes you make here or there. It'll give a smoky textured look to bits of metal and bits of war gear hanging off of them. And then once you've done the wash, highlight up using brighter colours, and you only need to do the edges of the armour, and you only need to touch up the guns with a grey and a lighter colour on the bits of detail here or there to get this look. White is the hardest thing to work with. You need to put a couple of layers on for it to really stand out. But that's it. Very happy with these. They'll make a nice addition to the army. I hope you learnt something from this video, and I'll see you in a future batrep.